I don't need a volunteer because these cards will be my volunteer. I will tell you all a little motivational speech story, and periodically I'll pull out a card and read whatever sentence is written on there, and then have to incorporate that in my story in a way that hopefully makes sense. So that's all there's to it, but I want a suggestion for what this should be about. So how about an activity or hobby, something random, something you don't hear about every day, a random activity or hobby? Dog sledding, okay. And let's spice it up a little bit. So how about a descriptive word, an adjective or adverb, but one you don't necessarily associate with dog sledding? Extreme? I'm sure some people would associate extreme with dog sledding, but that's fine. So I'm gonna share with you a motivational speech about the power of extreme dog sledding. Hopefully this is a fun way to end, but also see if you can catch some of the improv ideas I talked about, the saying yes and, the using the change to my advantage, the improviser's mindset, just all that stuff. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for joining me for my talk on the power of extreme dog sledding. You see, many years ago, I was kind of bored in my life, so I went on vacation to the far north, and you know, it was very cold up there, and I remember waking up in my hotel room saying to myself, that rug really tied the room together. There was this beautiful rug in the room, and I sat there and realized, oh my God, it's 11 in the morning, and I'm in a hotel room in this beautiful land, and I'm focused on the rug. I need to do something with my life. So I said, I don't know what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna get out. So I walked out of there, got my park on, I went out in the cold, and I saw this dog. And when I saw this dog standing there, I thought to myself, great, I can't read the handwriting. I thought to myself, have fun, be willing to fail. All right, I'm glad someone's taking notes. I was like, I saw this speaker speak at a recent conference in the Northwest, and he told me to have fun, be willing to fail. So I went up to the dog, said, I'm gonna have fun. So I started petting this dog, but then the dog bit me, and I'm like, what? And this woman screamed at me, and she yelled something. Oh my God, she was so mad at me. She yelled, hey, hey, Mr. Postman. I guess I look like the mailman because I was wearing like a navy parka. And I said, I'm not the postman. This dog just bit me. And she said, oh my God, I've been waiting for an important letter. I said, what letter have you been waiting for? And she looked at me, and I'll never forget her words. She said, ever tried, ever failed, no matter. Try again, fail better. I said, okay, well, then I failed because your dog bit me, but I'm gonna try again. So this time I went in and pet the dog again, which is crazy, but this time the dog let me, and I achieved the goal. And she was stunned. She's like, no one ever tries twice, and no one's ever succeeded. And that's when the thought hit me. It's a thought I would never have. It was like God himself said to me, in order to make the relationship work, you need to believe, like, and trust who you are working with. You guys are very motivational here. And I looked at this woman and I said, listen, I don't know you, but I like you. What were you gonna do? Can I join you? I trust you, I wanna work with you. And she said, well, I'm a dog sledder and I was about to take a tour out dog sledding. Do you wanna come? And I didn't. In fact, I had heard bad things about dog sledding. I remember my dad once said to me, you smell like beef and cheese. You don't smell like Santa. I remember that was from Christmas morning, and I remember that's the problem. I always had this beef and cheese smell, and then I realized that's why the dog bit me, because I smell like beef and cheese. So I said, wait here, let me take a shower. So I went, cleaned up, and came out, and this time when I pet the dog, he was fine. I no longer smell like beef and cheese. This woman was making my life better and improving my hygiene all at the same time. I said, I am ready to go with you. She said, well, let's go dog sledding, but there's one thing you must remember, and it is this. All true stories end in death. This is a true story. And we are just careening, and we are going through the trees, and we're heading for a cliff, and I'm like, oh my God, this is the most extreme thing I've ever done. And I'll tell you what, I was scared for my life, but I felt more alive in that moment than I had in my previous 40 years of existence. And we went careening over the cliff, and we were gonna die, when all of a sudden this parachute opened up, and she laughed at me, because she knew we were not gonna die, and she had lied to me. And I was so mad, I looked at her, and I said to her, enjoy the journey, and I cut her parachute. And she fell all the way down. Now, she didn't die either because we were pretty close to the ground already. And when I got down there, she said, I was so exhilarated. That was extreme. I said, I was exhilarated. That's extreme. And that's when we decided to go into business together with extreme dog sledding tours. Now, we take people out. We make them think they're going to die while dog sledding. And they love it more than anything. And we are very successful. And you might be sitting there saying to yourself, what does this have to do with me? Well, you've probably got some goal. There's probably some listlessness in your life. And you wake up in the morning and you look at yourself and you probably say, I want to hold your hand. Well, there's other people in the world. You don't have to hold your own hand. Get out in the world, right? If you're just sitting in the mirror holding your own hand, you can't go get, I needed that collaboration. You need that collaboration too. So if I can leave you with one final thought about the power of extreme dog sledding, it is this. You can't handle the truth. Thank you guys very much. Terrific audience. Please enjoy the rest of your conference.